welcome contestant number 44 in talent competition, Charity Case. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 44, Charity Case.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 33, Miss Valerie Lohr. Valerie Lohr.
Thank you, Lady Baronessa. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm going to give you a little brief biography of myself. And the best place to start is at the very beginning. It all started on November the 30th, 1960. So that makes me 29 years old. I was born in Fort Worth, Texas, a town not too far from here, also known as Cowtown, USA, where I grew up most of my life. Yeah, let's hear from Fort Worth. I had a wonderful childhood in Fort Worth, but I knew immediately that I marched to the beat of a different drum. And my parents knew that they were going to have problems when they found me putting Barbie doll dresses on my G.I. Joe. So, I went on and graduated from Amon G. Carter Riverside High School in Fort Worth, and then went on to college at North Texas State University, where I received a degree in the field of marketing. It was my senior year at North Texas that one Halloween I decided to dress up as a fairy princess. Well, trick or treat, here I am. Little did I know that that dressing up that Halloween would lead to something as fabulous as led me to here on this stage this evening. I created an illusion by the name of Valerie Lore, who's opened many doors for me and has shown me that female impersonation is a fabulous art form and a fabulous form of entertainment, not only to the straight community, but the straight community as well. Because I recently spent 14 weeks in Reno, Nevada, where I did work for a straight audience, and it was fabulous, and they loved us just as much as y'all do. I live here in Dallas, Texas now. Thank you. I live here in Dallas, Texas now. I've lived here for about 8 years now. I share my life with someone very special to me. He's the man behind the woman behind the man. It gets kind of confusing at times. And his name's Mr. John Mendez. And we live in Oak Cliff. We have a little house, our dog Pickles, and we couldn't be any happier. We couldn't be any happier. Thank you. But the key I want you to say, no matter how far you go in life, as long as you're happy, you are a success. And this evening, I feel like a terrific success. And I'd like to thank you all for making a lot of my dreams come true. Thanks a lot.
Contestant number 33, Miss Valerie Lore.
Hello. It's getting better. Shh. Trying to get me in trouble. I'm just looking. Don't do that. You want to get me fired? Now that voice sounded like Naomi Sims to me. That's a vicious plot to get rid of me. Excuse me? I know, do you hear? I didn't mention the word myself. I signed with this pen. Excuse me, darling? Does it work? What word? The P word? Chicken. Thank you. You know, one place I haven't been able to get to while I've been staying here in Dallas for the last week is one of my favorite little places, next to the Village Station, of course, is the Roundup. Oh, the Roundup just rounds me up, baby. One of the last, I think last year when I was here for Miss Gay America, they asked me to host some contests there when they were at the old place, which burned down. And it was different because I'm used to performing in clubs that have big stages and sound systems and just doing, this place was a little bitty country place and these people loved the show just as much. But the second week when I came in and performed with my illusion of divine, I think I scared the hell out of them. Please welcome, ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 46, Nakoma Shea.
Bye. fall in love because all the things that we've been through. You should understand me like I understand you. Baby, there's a difference between rock and roll. Wake up this happy home. Please trust in me like I trust in you. And as long as we're together, that could be so easy to do. Help me make it.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, that was contestant number 46, Nakoma Shea, sponsored by The Wave, John's Cabaret, Carmichael Enterprises, IBT. He didn't give me my cue. Okay. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, this unemployed hostess would like to welcome to the stage contestant number 48, Sweet Savage.
No, we have a mistake there.
Oh, I'm sorry, darling. Please forgive me. See, you all did it. You all did it. I'm terribly sorry. My apologies.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 34, Mahogany. Mahogany, why don't you give us a brief little something that you want us to know about you. I know you're nervous since Beulah was over there thinking of food all night long. Here you go.
Thank you, Baronessa. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, judges. I'm contestant number 34, Mahogany. My stage name is Amos Stanberry. I am originally from Plano, Texas. I am the ninth child born unto Mr. and Mrs. Clyde Stanberry. I went to school in Plano. There's one thing that my father told me is to always be my best and to be myself and not to try to be something else that I'm not. And tonight, I can only be myself. As far as drag is concerned, I'm sorry, drag. See, I can only be myself, right? I'm allowed to make one mistake, right? As I was saying, I was born into the family of parents of Mr. and Mrs. Clyde Stanberry, and my father did tell me to always be myself and not to be something that I'm not. And that thought carried on in my mind throughout the years. Right now, I can only think of him. My father passed away a year and a half ago. And tonight, I want him to know that I am being myself. I started female impersonation 1985 at a bar in Dallas called the Unicorn, which is basically all women. And to close, I would like to say happy anniversary, Selmore. Tonight is our ninth year anniversary.
Contestant number 34, Mahogany.
And please welcome contestant number 48, Sweet Savage.
Cherokee. My mother's people were ashamed of me. crowd.
Bang, bang.
That awful sound.
Bang, bang.
My baby shot me.
Thank you.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, that was contestant number 48, Sweet Savage, sponsored by Friends for Savage.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 35, Miss Brandy Alexander.
Thank you, Baroness. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen and judges. My name is Randy Finoli. I'm 25 years old, and I was born on a small farm in southern Illinois into a family of 7 children, believe it or not. I'm glad to be here, first of all, and I thank you very much. I'm a licensed cosmetologist, but for the past 5 years, I have been combining my talents as a makeup artist, fashion designer. thank you. Actor, choreographer, to create this illusion that I call Brandy Alexander. A lot of people see me on stage and they wonder what kind of person I am. And when you see a person on stage for a few minutes, you get this idea. But as a lot of my friends know, I'm just like anyone else. But I'm very goal-oriented, and I'm a very positive thinker, and I'm very optimistic. And I've got a lot of goals in my life, but along with these goals, I have ways to achieve them. At least I hope so. One of my biggest goals is to someday star in Hollywood in a movie. And so I'm currently writing a script starring a female impersonator. Another one of my goals is to become a fashion designer. And I know they didn't read our description cards tonight, but I made everything that I'm wearing in the contest. So I hope you liked it. Also this year, to achieve my goal into making it into TV, I was in a special on the Channel 9 News for 3 nights called The Truth About Brandy, and they brought me out as a female impersonator. Well, they brought me out as a woman first, and then on the second day, they showed that I was a man by, I flipped over my hair and I had beard growth on my face. And I shocked about 250,000 people. But the response was absolutely positive, and you cannot imagine the response that I've gotten since then. They really treat me well in Piccadilly Restaurant, okay? But I think out of all my goals in life, the most important goal that I have, and the biggest one, is to become a better person. I watch the news, and I see chaos. I see trouble, I see suffering, I see tragedy all over the world. And I think the only way that we can take care of that, the only way that we can change nations, governments, and worlds, is by changing individuals. Thank you, and good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 35, Miss Brandy Alexander.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, please welcome contestant number 50, the reigning Miss Gay Maryland, Jennifer Blake.
They got suspenders, so what can they lose? But what good are belts? What good suspenders? When the pants are hanging over the shoes, you feel a winter breeze up and down the knees. The belt is where the tie belongs. Cause Sam, 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 you made the pants to love. You know what I mean, Sam? And step around the heart of it, New York, New York. I want to wake up in the city that doesn't sleep, to find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. My little town, I'm melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'd make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York. New York, New York. I wanna wake up.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, that was contestant number 50, Jennifer Blake.
Oh, I didn't know. Okay.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 42, Miss Tiffany Bonet. Tiffany Bonet, why don't you give us a brief biography on yourself, love? Sorry about the confetti.
Thank you. If I can't imagine something, then deep within my heart, I know that I have the ability to achieve it. And as long as I can dream it, then I am determined to become it. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and judges. I'm contestant number 42, Tiffany Bonet. My given name is AC Hendricks, and I'm a 23-year-old resident of Winston-Salem, North Carolina. I'm currently employed as a formal wear specialist, and I've been a female impersonator for 4 years. In reference to my opening statement, ladies and gentlemen, that has become my motto in life, simply because it is my personal belief that no individual or group of people should be forced to accept limitations. I believe that each and every one of us can accomplish any of the goals that we set for ourselves in life, regardless of our race or our socioeconomic background. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, it is my belief that with the right amount of dedication, a never-ending perseverance, and with love and support from your family, your friends, and your lovers, that all things in life are possible. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 42, Miss Tiffany Bonet, our last contestant in interview. Now, before I leave with Tiffany, I would like to say thank you very much to three people. She told me that they're very nervous, her hands are like, but she said, I'll stand out there with you, Mom. But there's three people I want to thank very, very much. First of all, my daughter, which is sitting right over here on the corner. This is the first time she's ever seen me like this on stage in this great, big place. Thank you for coming. She flew down just for that. And also Mr. Andrew Kyle, who took 20 years off my life by putting all this makeup on my face and doing my hair and everything. The man is unbelievable. You're beautiful. Thank you so much. And to that lady that's standing right there at the podium who put me all together because at the last minute, everything fell apart on me. Thank you and good night. Come, Tiffany.
Contestant number 52, Coco.
Thank you. was coming, number one without a doubt. Funny when the kids hear always I was clean swimming like a little fish under a heavy rock. Using you've been working with me on the love, and he's been only playing on the cup all the while. Take a chicken up another look into his eyes, and you were only a reptile. You were going to make that man, you were a then he called you up. Now. Hey baby, you got to remember that forever your girl.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, that was our last contestant of talent competition, contestant number 52, Coco. Guess what? I'm supposed to stay here and talk to you for a little bit. Vicki Vincent, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment pleasure, please welcome our reigning symbol of excellence, Miss Gay America, Vicki Vincent.
You For 1989. Did we enjoy talent? Are we ready for evening wear? Well, before we start evening wear, we've got a couple of more thank yous we'd like to do. I'd like to start off with our transportation this year was by My Limo of Dallas. We'd also like to thank our floral designs, which were the greens you envy. Our scenic designer was Chris Lester. Our printing was by Abacus Printing. Our layout and design was by Dallas Voice. Our pageant musical director this year was Joe Delane. So are we ready for evening wear? This is my favorite part of the Miss America pageant, just because I love evening gowns. So if I can, let's bring to the stage our 10 finalists in evening wear competition for the 1989 Miss Gay America pageant. I'm sorry, we're not ready yet. Starting off with contestant number 31, Cody Collins. Cody comes to us from Huntington, West Virginia. Tonight, Cody is proudly sponsored by Pageant Enterprise. Her horoscope is Aries. She is 5'10". Her weight is 140. Her eyes are of blue, and her hair, well, is blonde. This is contestant number 31 in evening wear competition, Cody Collins. Let's bring to the stage now contestant number 32, Valerie Lohr. Valerie is from your very own city of Dallas, Texas. And she is proudly sponsored this year by the Vanettes of Kansas City, Missouri, Hartford's, Sue Ellen's, and the Roundup. She's also sponsored by The Wave, PM Productions, and Val's Pals. Valerie's goals in life right now are to become a Miss Gay America and to own her own business. Her hobbies include designing and fabric painting, people watching, and collecting miniatures. This is contestant number 33, an evening gown competition, Valerie Lohr. Let's bring to the stage contestant number 34, Mahogany. Mahogany is the currently running Miss Gay Delaware 1990. Tonight she is sponsored by Lamont Production, Trey Chic, The Renaissance, Sue Ellen's, The Greens You Envy, and a blue parrot. His sign is Aries, and his hobbies include jogging, computers, fishing, traveling, and drawing. Ladies and gentlemen, this is contestant number 34, Mahogany. And now enters contestant number 35, Randy Alexander. Randy is the currently running Miss Great Plains of America. Randy is proudly sponsored by George's Lounge, The Hideaway, The Max, Street Talk, Jimmy Hilliard, Joel and Corey, and friends and fans of Brandy Alexandra. Her sign is Aquarius. She enjoys sewing, dancing, talking on the phone, and spending wild and crazy nights in New Orleans. Brandy is 5'8 and weighs 125 pounds. Brandy would like to someday own her own fashion design company and to star in a movie. Ladies and gentlemen, this is contestant number 35 in evening wear competition, Brandy Alexander. Is the currently running Miss Gay Illinois. She comes to you from St. Louis, Missouri, where she is proudly sponsored by Magnolias, Monty's, Knights, Faces, and Charities Hollywood Blonde. Charity is a Leo, and her hobbies are traveling, shopping, and studying classical opera. Charity's eyes are of green, and her hair is brown, and her health is excellent. This is contestant number 44 in evening wear competition, Charity Case. If you will, let's put our hands together for contestant number 46, Nakoma Shea. Nakoma is the currently reigning Miss Gay Arlington, and she is also your first alternative to Miss Gay Texas. Nakoma makes her home here in Dallas, Texas, where she is proudly sponsored by The Wave, John L's Cabaret, Carmichael's International, and IBT's Texans in Arizona. He is a Cancer, and loves traveling, cooking, songwriting, and old movies. He has hazel eyes and light brown hair. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, contestant number 46, Nakoma Shea. Let's bring to the stage contestant number 48, Sweet Savage. Sweet Savage makes her home here, right in the state of Texas. He has brown hair and brown eyes. Sweet Savage's hobbies include shopping, shopping, and more shopping. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 48 in evening wear competition, Sweet Savage.